हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज डॉक्टर अशोक कुमार फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट वुमेन इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज अजमेर। दिस इज ए न्यू सीरीज एंड नेम्ड एज एंटीना पैरामीटर्स एंड दिस इज लेक्चर वन ऑफ दिस सीरीज एंटीना पैरामीटर्स एंड इनिशियली वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द रेडिएशन पैटर्न करेक्टरिस्टिक्स। द फॉलोइंग कंटेंट्स विल बी आउटलाइंड during this lecture 1 of antenna parameter series, and in which we are going to discuss about radiation pattern, their lobes, then isotropic, directional and omnidirectional patterns, principal planes, I mean E plane and H plane, beam width, field regions and radian and steradian. These following contents will be addressed this lecture 1 of antenna parameter series. The content of this lecture is prepared with the help of these following books. As we have discussed that antenna act as an interface between a guided wave and a free space wave. We can say that antenna is a transitional device through which we can convert guided wave into the free space wave when we are using transmitting mode, and vice versa when we are using in a receiving mode. For the efficient interface between the free space wave and guided wave in the free transmission line, the input impedance of the antenna must be matched to the characteristic impedance of the transmission line. So this is very, very important characteristics in the case of antenna. I mean, at input terminals, Z in equal to the Z naught is the characteristic impedance. Then Z in equal to Z naught, in that case the antenna is a best radiator, and we can say it's a best or efficient interface between the free space and guided wave. So the antenna characteristics we can classify in two main categories, and these categories are radiation characteristics and input characteristics. Any antenna can be characterized in two categories, and in which the radiation categories are used to describe the way the antenna radiate or receive energy from a space, and include radiation pattern, gain, directivity, effective aperture, polarization, etc. I mean, these parameters are relevant to the radiation characteristics of the antenna, while the second category is the input characteristics, and which are used to specify the performance of the antenna looking into its terminals and specified in terms of input impedance, bandwidth, reflection coefficient, voltage standing wave ratio, etc. So we can say any antenna can be characterized with the radiation and input characteristics, and these are some certain parameters, and these certain parameters we will discuss in this lecture or in the subsequent lectures of antenna parameter series. So first we have considered the radiation pattern, and radiation pattern can be broadly defined in three categories, or according to different books or according to different references. An antenna radiation pattern or antenna pattern is defined as a mathematical function of a graphical representation of the radiation properties of the antenna as the function of space coordinates. So we can say, what are the radiation properties according to definition? We will discuss shortly. Other definition, we can say the radiation pattern or antenna pattern is defined as the spatial distribution of the quantity that characterize the electromagnetic field, EM field, generated by the antenna. So we can characterize EM field through some special distribution of a quantity, and the quantity we will discuss shortly. Third definition is that the radiation pattern describes a collective of electric or magnetic field, we can say electromagnetic waves, strength at a fixed distance in the far field of the antenna. Suppose one antenna is putting at the origin at a distance, far field distance, which we are considering is 2d square by lambda, where d is equal to maximum diameter of the antenna, r is the distance from the source to the observation point. In that case, we can describe the collective of electric and magnetic fields. So according to three theories or three definitions, we can say that the properties, quantities are referred to above definition could be the field strength or field amplitude, power means power density, radiation intensity, antenna polarization, directivity, relative phase, etc. So these are the properties or quantity through which we can describe the radiation pattern in terms of graphical representation of the radiation properties of the antenna as a function of space coordinates or spatial distribution of the quantity that characterize the electromagnetic field generated by the antenna. So we have considered what kind of coordinates we are using to define or to understand the antenna characterization. So we have considered the coordinate system for the antenna analysis. So here you can see we are considering the spherical coordinate system through which we can understand the analysis, antenna analysis in terms of their coordinate systems. So here you can see this is XYZ plane and antenna putting on a origin, this is origin we can consider, and the antenna is radiating, suppose this type of radiation pattern here you can see. So in this figure you can see the maximum radiation occurs along the Z direction. So we can say the antenna, if a wire antenna, so we can put along the X axis or along the Y axis, but aperture antenna we can put along the XY axis. So the maximum radiation occurs along the Z direction. So we are taking the radius R as per the spherical coordinate system, the angle phi from the X axis and angle theta from the Z axis. A small element we have considered, and this is a small element, and this small element having the radius r from the origin and unit field vector ar, a theta and a phi. Here you can see this is a phi from the z axis, so unit vector exists from the z axis, a of theta. Here you can see this angle is the phi. In that case you can see this is represent a of phi or a of phi, and this is a of r along the direction from the origin to the observation point, we can say. So we have considered a small element, and this element area can be calculated by calculating their curvature dimension. So here you can see this dimension is r into d theta, and this dimension equal to r sin theta and d phi. By using simple geometry you can calculate, then we can calculate the area of small element that we have considered on a sphere, d of a is equal to r square sin theta d theta and d phi. So this is the geometrical representation, and some more findings can be outlined from this figure, that some planes, that is elevation plane and azimuth plane, and some lobes also exist in this pattern, is the major lobe and minor lobes we can see. So this planes and the lobes we will discuss in the subsequent slide, but here we are using spherical coordinate system, and you can see and having the radiation pattern along the Z direction. So this is the standard we are using, If you want to change the axis, in that case, their characteristics also changes, their planes also changes, other things should be remain same. So this is the analysis of the antenna in terms of their coordinate system. So we can say we are using spherical coordinate systems. So for a antenna, we can characterize the pattern into the three forms. First is the power pattern in linear scale, second is the power pattern in linear scale, and power pattern in dB. So we can say the field pattern means a plot of magnitude of electric or magnetic field as a function of angular space. Similarly, power pattern, a plot of square of the magnitude of electric or magnetic field as a function of angular space. So we can say the field pattern is proportional to E. We can say E is the electric, or H for the magnetic. But in the power pattern, we can calculate the E of square or M of square. But in a power pattern, we can represent in dB also is the magnitude of electric or magnetic field in decibel as the function of angular space. So we can draw the radiation pattern in three forms according to. Generally, we are using power pattern form, and we can say that field and power pattern can be normalized with respect to their maximum value, yielding normalized field and power pattern. So we can say the radiation pattern we have drawn always in terms of normalized field and power patterns. Also, the power pattern usually plotted on a logarithmic scale or more commonly in decibels. So this is we have analyzed. So here you can see we have considered a two-dimensional normalized pattern. Here you can see in a linear scale and in a decibel scale. Here you can see is the field pattern in linear scale, power pattern in linear scale, and power pattern in dB. And these we have to normalize, and you can see this is a red color indicate that the maxima, and this blue color indicate the minima. So we can say we have normalized with respect to the maximum value. Here you can see the main lobe exists, suppose along the z direction, in, or we can say in a linear scale. And here you can see some important analysis or important parameters you will get, and that will be discussed. And these are the radiation pattern we have considered for a 10 element linear array with a spacing of d is equal to 0.25. And this is only for the understanding purpose, that how we can understand the normalized field pattern or power pattern. So here you can see one important parameter is the maxima. Here you can see having value 1. Here you can see having value 1. But when we have to calculate in terms of dB, then we are getting 0. Another important thing that you will get from this, the beam width, half power beam width. So here you can see if the pattern is in amplitude form, in that case half power beam width is the 1 by root 2, which is equal to 0.707. if it is power pattern, in that case, which is equal to 1 by 2, so we can say is the 0.5. so this is the angular separation, that is called the half power beam width. Here you can see this is the angular separation at 0.707. it is a half power beam width in the amplitude pattern, or we can say field pattern, I mean E or H field. This is power pattern, and here you can see in terms of dB. So when we are calculating in terms of dB, then you will get at 3 dB points. These are the 2.3 dB. So this is the angular separation. It is called the half power beam width. So we can easily understand that half power beam width in a field pattern we have defined 1 by root 2, in power pattern 1 by 2, and in terms of dB is a 3 dB below from the maxima. This is maxima, and this is the 3 dB below from the maxima. This is this radiation pattern is only understanding purpose, to understand the field pattern, power pattern in terms of linear or in terms of dB, and their value, half power beam width. And further we are going to discuss about the LOPS. So here you can see one example we have considered, or we can see it's a generic radiation pattern. And again we can see this is the major lobe, this is the half power beamwidth as we have discussed earlier, this is the null beamwidth where there is no radiation exists, these are the minor lobes, and this is the back lobe just opposite to the main lobe here you can see, and this is the side lobe, and the side lobes are the those lobes which are in the periphery of the main lobe here you can see, or we can say this is first side lobe also FSL, first side lobe level we can say, and these are the minor lobes we can say, and this radiation pattern we have normalized to the maximum value and which is equal to 1. Again we can understand in terms of 2D pattern, or we can say it's a linear plot. So here you can see this is the radiation intensity that will be discussed later, and this is the angular separation theta here you can see. So this is the main lobe, this is the side lobe, or we can say it's a first side lobe, and these are the minor lobes, and this is the back lobes just opposite to the main lobe, this is the back lobe. So these are some important radiation pattern lobes that we'll need to understand, and this is the half power beamwidth and first null beamwidth. So here you can see the radiation is zero, and here you can see according to field pattern or power pattern in terms of linear or in terms of dB you can define the value of field or value of power in terms of linear or in terms of dB. These radiation pattern we have discussed, so we can summarize that the major lobe is also called a main lobe, and it is the lobe along the direction of the maximum radiation. It is the lobe except a major lobe. So here you can see these all are the side lobes we can say. Side lobe, it is a radiation lobe in any direction other than the intended lobe. Usually it is adjacent to the main lobe and occupies the hemisphere in the direction of the main beam. So we can say this is the side lobe we can generally categorize, and this side lobe is adjacent to the, or we can say intended lobe in the periphery of intended lobe it exists. So we can say side lobe, it is first, then it is called a first side lobe. Back lobe, the radiation lobe that makes an angle of about 180 degree with the main lobe, as we have discussed, 0 degree and sorry, here you can see 0 degree and this is the 180 degree, and the nulls in the pattern indicate along this direction, that is radiation is 0. Further we have to discuss about isotropic directional and omnidirectional patterns. So we can generally define the isotropic radiator is defined as the hypothetical lossless antenna having equal radiation in all directions. Physically this type of radiator is not exist practically, but we can measure some important characteristic, or we can analyze some important antenna characteristics with respect to the isotropic radiator. A directional antenna is having the properties of radiating or receiving electromagnetic waves more effectively in some direction than in other. This term is usually applied to antenna whose maximum directivity is significantly greater than that of the half wave dipole. So directional antenna can be defined that antenna having the directivity more than the half wave dipole antenna. So we can consider the best example for a directional antenna is the horn antenna, and we will discuss about the detailed analysis of the horn antenna in the separate lectures. An omnidirectional is defined as the having an essentially non-directional pattern in a given plane that in at this case is the azimuth, and directional pattern in any orthogonal plane that this is in that case is the elevation. So as we have discussed during the coordinate analysis, there's azimuth and elevation plane. So we can define the omnidirectional pattern, and this is a special type of directional pattern, and we have measured in the two principal planes, I mean azimuth and elevation angle. And the best example of this omnidirectional antenna is the dipole antenna, and that we have discussed in a dipole antenna series separately. And we have measured in azimuth and elevation plane, so we can say the omnidirectional antenna is the special type of directional antenna. Further, the principal planes, so we can categorize the radiation pattern principal planes in two categories. First is the E plane and second is the H plane. So the plane containing the electric field vector and the direction of maxima radiation, I means E and direction of maxima radiation, is called as the E plane. And H plane is the plane containing the magnetic field, I mean H, and the direction of maximum radiation. So here you can see one, it is a radiation pattern of generic antenna, and this type of radiation pattern we have also discussed earlier. Here you can see this is type of radiation pattern, but important we are going to calculate their principal planes and their major cut planes, that is needed to understand the properties of radiation properties of the antenna. So here you can see the antenna is radiated along the z direction. So we can say if the antenna is aperture, so we are putting in the xy plane, or if the antenna is linearly polarized, so we can put it on a along the x axis. In that case we have to calculate the radiation pattern along the z direction. So in that case, some important is the major cut plane, and then major cut plane we can calculate at phi is equal to phi dash. So these are the major cut plane in the radiation pattern. So here you can see xz plane is the E plane, where the value of phi is equal to 0 degree, and the copolarized component is the E theta, and cross polarized component is the E phi. Similarly, in the yz plane, it's called a H plane, and having the value of phi equal to 90 degree and E of phi and is the copolarized field, and E of theta is the cross polarized field. So these are the major cut plane, and these major cut planes only applicable only one case, when the antenna radiate maximum radiation along the z direction. So this is important, and in that case we have defined some principal planes. And here you can see some important parameters, half power beamwidth, that we have also discussed, but in the form of copolarized field and cross polarized field, and how we can define. So beamwidth is defined as the angular range between two identical points on opposite side of pattern maxima. Here you can see we can discuss, so this is the pattern maxima, and this we have to define E max square. So we can calculate the half power beamwidth is the angular range in which E co square greater than equal to 0.5 E max ka square. So here you can see E maxima square means, so we can say this is a power pattern, and in that case the E copolarized component having the value greater than equal to 0.5 of E max square, and it is usually referred in terms of dB, which is equivalent to the 3 dB beamwidth. The first null beamwidth is the angular range in which eco square is equal to 0, or angular separation between the first null of the pattern. So here you can see, and suppose this is having the zero radiation, in that case we can calculate the first null beamwidth. And when we can define some important relation between the half power beamwidth and first null beamwidth, and which is equal to half power beamwidth is equal to first nearly approximately equal to fn bw divided by 2. So this is very important relation, and that is needed to calculate the half power beamwidth and first null beamwidth for any type of antenna. And further we are going to discuss about the field region. So this is the field region of any generic antenna, and in that case you can see we are considering one some kind of dipole antenna, and we are putting on the center, or we can say at the origin, and having the diameter d, and we can define the field region into the three forms, that is reactive near field region, radiating near field, or we can say Fresnel region, and far field Fraunhofer region. So according to region, we can define the field regions and we can calculate the value of R1 is the radius, R2 is the radius, and we can calculate R1 is equal to 0.62 root of T3 by lambda. If the value is greater than or equal to, this is the boundary actually we are saying. So we can say the value in a radiating near field region, R1 should be equal to this one. And when in we have measured in a far field region, or we can say Fraunhofer region, in that case R2 is equal to 2D square by lambda. So this is the minimum distance actually. So we generally we are calculating the radiation characteristics of the antenna in a far field region. So the minimum distance is required R2, which is equal to 2D square by lambda, or generalized we can define for measuring the characteristics of the antenna in a far field region. The distance is equal to 2d square, greater than equal to 2d square by lambda. So we can also understand this far field region in terms of their pattern, or we can say so electric field pattern. So in a reactive field region, the pattern is more spread out and nearly uniform in a slight variation. So we can say some kind of slight variation and looks like a constant pattern here you can see. But as the observation is moved to the radiating near field, as we are moving from reactive region to the radiating near field region, in that case the pattern begins to smith and creates or forms some lobes in that case. But in the far field region, this is we can represent the far field region, in that case the pattern is well formed, usually consists of the minor lobes and one or more major lobes. So this is the far field region. Further, we are going to discuss about the radian and stadian, and this is used to analyze the characteristics of the antenna mathematically. So the measure of the plane angle is a radian. So this is the radian. So we can say it's a plane angle, and stadian is a solid angle. So here you can see this is the solid angle for calculating the stadian. And we can define the radian is the plane angle with its vertex at the center of a circle of a radius r. This is the radius r that is subtended by an arc whose length is equal to r. So we can say this is equal to the 1 radian. And according to figure 6a, the circumference of the circle is r, is c is equal to 2 pi r. So the radian r 2 pi radian, so we can say 2 pi upon r is a in a full circle. So we can say radian we have measured, this is the total, so we can say it is 2 pi radian. Similarly, stadian is a solid angle, and we can define solid angle with its vertex. Here you can see at the center of the sphere of the radius r, that is subtended by the spherical surface area, equal to the square of the each side of length r. Here you can see. So this is here you can see. So we have measured, this is the 1 stadian, and the area of the sphere of a radius r is a is equal to 4 pi r square. There are 4 pi stadian, 4 pi r square in a closed sphere. So this is here in the radian it is 2 pi, and stadian it is the 4 pi stadian. So we can calculate the infinitesimal area dA on the surface of the sphere r, as we have discussed in figure 1 during the coordinate system analysis for a antenna. In that case we can calculate d of a is equal to r square sin theta, and this is the small element area that we have considered along the, and we have calculated the curvature lengths r d phi and r sin theta d theta, and we have to multiply it, and we can calculate dA, which is equal to r square sin theta d theta and d phi. This is needed for calculating the radiation characteristics of the antenna and solving the problems based on these antenna. And the element solid angle d of ohm of a sphere can be calculated. D of ohm is equal to d of a upon r square. So we can see sin theta d theta and d phi. So we have measure in terms of steadian. So in this lecture 1 of antenna parameter series, we have discussed mainly the radiation pattern characteristics and associated the term to the radiation pattern, mainly the lobes, half power beamwidth, and the major cut plane, principal plane, and principal planes, I mean E plane and H plane, and the isotropic radiator, directional and omnidirectional radiation patterns that we have discussed in this lecture. In the subsequent lecture, we are going to discuss about some other important parameter that are relevant to the antenna pattern, in which we are going to discuss about the power density, radiation intensity, directivity, etc. in the subsequent lecture 2 of this antenna parameter series. Thank you everyone for watching this lecture. I hope this lecture is beneficial for you.